come vorresti essere ricordato tra 100 anni.
All right, I confess, I'm not the world's number one fan of operas. In fact, I rarely have ever have gone to one in a theater, especially one that is not in English, where I don't understand a word they're singing. I certainly have seen opera on screen in different places, but never really appreciated it. I know a lot of people do, and that's great, and the talent is extraordinary, no question about it. But I have to say, the new movie from Ron Howard, the director Ron Howard, Pavarotti, is changing my tune. There's no question about it, at least as far as this magnificent star who brought opera to the masses.
My mother says, my son sing with a beautiful voice. I say, Mama, you say that because you are my mother. No, because I don't say that when I hear your father.
Ron Howard has suddenly become very interested in musical documentaries. He really hadn't made a documentary. His long career, Oscar-winning career, certainly done films that dealt with real-life people, real-life stories like A Beautiful Mind, Apollo 13, on and on like that. But never in this vein. Then he did the Beatles 8 days a week about their touring years. And he did a film with the Jay-Z called Made in America. And he's a natural here at telling a story and getting to the essence of the emotion of this story. And that is what is so great about this music. Man, it just soars. This is a movie that must be seen in a theater because the sound is incredible. 3-time Oscar winner Chris Jenkins is a sound designer. What he did was he went back and essentially remastered and reorchestrated a lot of these great performances of Pavarotti. They went around into Abbey Road Studios with different mics, and you have got a sound that you have never heard on screen before in terms of these performances. It's absolutely magnificent. It really falls right in line now with the slew of musical movies, whether they're documentaries or narrative films. The music is back in movies in a big way, but in a different way. This movie is also great because they went and shot 53 new interviews, and nothing was off limits, including his first wife and his 3 daughters, who give very raw and honest interviews on camera. His last wife, who opened up the archives and made this all possible because she feels like his legacy should be shared with the world.
He was crushed by injustice.
He became completely obsessed by what he could do for others.
Just having him there singing and all of that would not be enough, but you really get the feeling here through all the interviews and the way this is all put together, how extraordinary the life of Luciano Pavarotti was and what he brought to us. One of my favorite moments here is with Bono, who comes in and shows how he twisted his arm, got him to perform because he was also a great philanthropist, and he got Bono to perform, and that stuff is just pure gold. Great interview. But there's a lot more like that. This is a movie worth checking out, definitely in a theater. Ron Howard did a great job, and I say, go.